Hey kids, today we're making ribbon meatloaf.
It's YouTube's best for creative things. It's cooking and crafting.
Hey kids. You guys, guess what I found? I was going through my mom's granny's old recipe box, and remember I told you about that ribbon meatloaf a while ago, and I said, oh, I don't remember it ever having like the sauce and whatnot. Well, I found it, yays! And okay, this is perfect because we need 2 pounds of hamburger, and I got up late today and didn't get the meat taken out early enough, so part of it is still frozen, so I'm gonna leave the frozen part behind. Let me get all that in there and get all this in here, and then I have already minced a small onion. We're just gonna need some salt and pepper and whatever kind of stuffing that you like to prepare. It just has to be a herb flavored bread stuffing mix. I used stovetop, and I have that already completed and ready on the side. Whoopsies, hold on, small technical difficulty. And I'm going to put in that minced onion. I rinse my hands off, and then some salt and pepper. They say about a teaspoon of salt and a few grains of pepper. So, teaspoon of salt. Five, six, seven, do you think that's a few grains? And a half a cup of milk. And I am going to mix this thoroughly. I have the oven preheated already at 350 degrees Fahrenheit. And I have sprayed my 9x5 bread pan. And like I said, I already have the stuffing already prepared. So what we're gonna do, I get that, I want all those onions in there because I love onions on top of loving garlic. All right, so move this here. Let me focus you in closer. There we go. And a little better lighting, how's that? I'm going to take this hamburger and I'm gonna divide it kinda sorta into three, into thirds, and I'm going to pat that down into the pan, and then I'm going to get the stuffing that I already prepared, and I'm going to put half of the stuffing on top of that. Nice and hot. Oh my gosh, I cannot believe that I found this. I was so excited when I saw it because I had been looking for this recipe that we always called Korean fried chicken, and there's nothing really Korean about it except that it might have, I mean, it has sesame seeds in it. But it's really delish. And so I didn't film it because I wasn't quite sure what to name it. My niece said, you could always call it yummy chicken. All right, so there's that first layer. Here comes the second layer of hamburger. Oh, I should have kind of made that a little bit less there. Wow, is this all gonna fit? I don't know. Here goes our second layer of stuffing. And I think I'm gonna put it all in. Because, you know what, I think I'm going to have to put this on a baking sheet, actually. So that, because one of them had, is 80-20, and the other one was 93-7 fat content. So, I'm afraid that the fat is going to seep over the sides. That stuffing is really hot. Alrighty, and then our last, wait, that's not full all the way. There we go. And our last bit of hamburger to go on top of that. Oh man, I didn't divide that up very well, did I? I'm gonna work at that. We are going to throw this into that 350 degree oven for 1 hour and 15 minutes. Let me even that out. I'll be back. Ugh. Can I turn you? Okay, I got it as pretty as humanly possible. So that's gonna go into that oven. Hey, let me know below in the description box if you want me to start digging through Granny's recipe box. That is exactly how I remember it. Ribbon meatloaf, enjoy. I don't even have to tell you how delicious this is because I know it is. We grew up eating this. It's absolute comfort food. Enjoy.